tester.co.uk.
Hello YouTubers, and welcome to this review of the DMMCHECK Plus by voltagestandard.com. So the gent who runs voltagestandard.com is Doug. Now, if you follow my multimeter reviews, you know I've been using his products for a while to act as a reference when I'm checking the accuracy of the multimeters. And I have two other of his products, the DMMCHECK and the Pentarep, so we'll have a quick look at those. But we'll go down to the bench, we'll look at the functionality on the DMMCHECK Plus, and I'll check it as best as I can with my 6.5-digit multimeter to see how accurate it is. So let's get down to the bench and have a look. Right, so as I said, I do have two other products which are done by Doug or voltagestandard.com. I've got the original DMMCHECK. I then have something called the Pentaref, which has 5 voltage references. And then I have the DMMCHECK Plus. Now, the prices of these at the moment, as it stands on his website, the DMMCHECK Plus goes for around $58-$59. I think the Pentaref goes for around the $55 mark. The DMMCHECK Plus goes for about $35. Now, first of all, just a quick overview of what these devices are used for, if you haven't yet realized. These are used as a reference check for, let's say, your digital multimeter. A high-grade scientific reference that's in a lab will cost a lot of money, and they have to be kept under very specific conditions. So these devices, which are produced by Doug, are ideal for the kind of home user, hobbyist, enthusiast, if you want a reference to double check that your multimeter is giving a good reading. Now, Doug has the bigger brother of a Hewlett-Packard scientific digital multimeter. I've got the 3457A, which is a 6.5/7.5-digit multimeter. Doug has the 3458A, and that is an 8.5-digit. And there's a big jump up to the kind of accuracy and resolution that that device has. And it costs a fair amount of money to maintain it and have it calibrated. So I think the pricing of these devices are really, really, really good. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is give you a quick overview of the two devices, and then we'll concentrate on the DMMCHECK Plus. So first, what I've got here, I've got my Amprobe multimeter connected up to the Pentaref. And I've had these devices switched on for a while, just to let them settle. If you do want good readings, you want them switched on for a little bit. They are powered by 9-volt batteries. The Pentaref is powered by 2 9-volt batteries. The DMMCHECK Plus and the DMMCHECK are powered by a single 9-volt battery, as you can see underneath. Now, the one thing to note also is in the handling, always try to hold it by the edges. Try not to avoid touching the circuitry. Eve, a very kind gent up in Canada, did produce this very nice little hole case to keep my DMMCHECK safe, so that even if it kind of falls over, it gives its weight and protection. And I'll just note up front, these aren't available commercially, because I know some people have been asking me. It was especially he made one for himself, and he sent one over to me, so a big thanks to him for that. Now, the Pentaref basically has obviously an on-off switch, and then it has a little contact switch over here to select different voltage references. I'll bring you in a little closer, and then I'll show you that on the multimeter. Something I also want to point out with these devices, if you really want to make easy use of them, it does make sense to have these little grippers or grabbers, these clips, or a small set of crocodile clips. It can be, if you're using bigger crocodile clips or just trying to hold your probes on here, sometimes it can be a bit fiddly and things start moving around the desk. So again, I'm going to also say a big thank you to Frankie Tong, who sent me a nice set of leads, which we'll look at in another video. Now, on this device, as you can see, I've got the multimeter connected, and it actually lists, and you can specify what reference voltages you want within reason to Doug, and then he'll specifically calibrate this device to the references that you want. And these were the voltage ranges that I wanted. So the first one is 0.2499 volts, You can see the LED obviously indicates that it's on that setting. And you can see my amp probe is not too far off that actually. You push the button again, it'll then go down to the next reference, and obviously you can check that on your multimeter. 5 volt reference, 7.7500 volt reference, and then a 9.9500 volt reference. So as you can see for this multimeter over here, now this is a 50,000 count multimeter. So let's just go back to the 5 volt reference. So that goes down, that's got 4 decimal places. So as you can see, this device caters for up to a 50,000 count multimeter in the number of digits that it actually goes to. So again, really, really handy. It does cover a broad range of equipment. So that's the Pentaref. Let's just have a quick look at the DMM check. Right, so here I have the DMM check. It obviously has a power on switch and an LED to indicate that it is actually powered on. It has 3 reference resistors on the side over here. It's got a pickup for current, 1 milliamp reference on the side here, and then the pickup over here is for a 5 volt reference. So as you can see at the moment, I've got it on the 5 volt reference and taking a reading. We can then obviously, if we want to check the current, we remove those. We obviously then need to switch over to our milliamp jack. Pull the device around, make sure I get the polarity correct. And there we go, there is the 1 milliamp reference. Obviously you can take it down to microamps as well if we want a bit more resolution just to check that. Next we'll have a look at the resistors. Right, so we're going to check the resistors. Now important something to note here is that you need to double check the resistance that's in your leads, because if you are trying to obviously use this as a reference, you're potentially going to have a little bit of deviation because there's obviously a loss in your leads or there's resistance in your test leads. So the best thing to do is obviously clip them together, and then you'll see there's some resistance there, perhaps not very much, and then use your delta button to take that out. And then you can go ahead and obviously clip onto your references. In this case, there's a 1K reference and it's noted at 999.3 ohm. And for this multimeter, certainly not far off that mark. There is then a 10K reference here, which is noted as 9.997K. This multimeter is not that far off. And the last reference is 100K, which is 99.95K. Now Doug's very good with all these devices. As you'll see when I introduce you to the DMMCHECK Plus, he does have a document which explains the usage and the tolerance of the actual references themselves. So he does go to a lot of effort in terms of that information. Right, let's have a close look at the DMMCHECK Plus. Right, so here we have the DMMCHECK Plus. I will bring you in closer for a little look. I just want to point out a few bits and pieces. Doug does obviously, as I said, give you a nice sheet explaining the usage and precautions. You obviously get an idea here. He notes you obviously get 4 resistors. You get a DC voltage of 5 volts with plus minus 0.01%. A DC current, 1 milliamp. AC voltage, also 5 volts. He notes here bipolar square wave, and we'll come back to that. There's something important to note about that. There's an AC current of 1 milliamp RMS, a frequency 100 hertz at 0.02%, and then a duty cycle of 100 hertz 5 volts RMS. And that is obviously 50%. Now, Doug does offer the option of varying some of these parameters. He does state it on the sheet here. The other very nice important thing to note is that Doug does offer recalibration service. Within the first 2 years, you just send it back and you include $3 worth of stamps for return shipping and you get it back. So you get a free calibration, and after that the calibration charge is $5 plus shipping, which I think is really, really fair. So the other thing to note is that with the DMMCHECK Plus, you get this little, obviously, data sheet with the noted values as he's measured them on his very accurate high-resolution multimeter. The one important thing to note is the calibration temperature, because obviously components and references do drift through temperature. Now, obviously, he's used for the money, he's used the components which have the kind of best stability that you can get for the price range. So they're not going to drift too much with a bit of temperature variance, but he will note that on his website, you can actually go and see what the drift is. He also notes at what temperature he calibrated it at, so that I can tell, like today, we're sitting at 25, 26 degrees Celsius, which is a little bit above the 70 degree Fahrenheit. But if you obviously had more extreme temperatures, you might just want to note that obviously you might have a bit of drift on the device. Right, so let's just have a quick closer look at the device. He does have them obviously serial numbered because he obviously has a note of all the products that he produces. It's got a power switch over here. It's got the LED to indicate that it's on. It has a switch over here to switch between the AC and DC references or measurements that you're going to make. On the side here, it's got the four reference resistors, and they're connected in series. So you can obviously, if you want to check other ranges, you can link up across these and obviously then note the value across them as opposed to just doing measurements across them individually. He's then got the hookups over here for voltage, and you can see the polarity, a positive and negative. Obviously for AC, that isn't a problem, but for a DC, you obviously note the polarity. And then over here is the pickup for current. On the underside is where you plug in the 9-volt battery, and he has taken caution. He's got polarity protection, so if you do connect the battery the wrong way around, that's not going to harm the device. The one thing to note though, besides obviously switching it on, being aware of the temperature, is static. You want to make sure that you discharge yourself, because obviously a big static discharge might damage the operation and the accuracy of the device. Then also you've got to be careful about remembering when you change your multimeter, if you've got it hooked up incorrectly and you're shorting an output, it won't immediately cause any damage, but it may cause excess heat on the device, which could set the accuracy of the device off. So you just need to be a little bit cautious with how you handle it. But otherwise, certainly if you do handle it carefully for the workbench and the hobbyist, it doesn't have to be stored in a glass case or under very specific conditions as you would for normal scientific equipment. Right, so one of the points I want to pick up on, kind of as I just show you the references and before we kind of get to a really high resolution meter to kind of check the device, is that I've got here an averaging multimeter. In other words, it's not true RMS, and then my amp probe over here is a true RMS meter. Now at the moment I've got the device set to the DC setting as a 5-volt reference, and obviously you can see that on the 2 meters. I'm now going to switch it to AC and switch both the meters to AC, and according to the actual reference note that's provided here, so the AC voltage is 4.999. And if we have a look at the amp probe's doing an excellent job here. It's actually going to 4 places, just a little bit of a flutter, but basically very near the reference. But the, as you can see, the fluke has got that increase, and that's because it's an averaging multimeter. And again, I need to do a review and a tutorial on this so that I better understand it and can and actually display this. But these are set up, as I understand, to average a sinusoidal wave. So because this is outputting a square wave, that's where this meter will then obviously doesn't average that correctly, and you get a higher reading, where obviously a true RMS is doing a proper RMS reading of a signal coming into it. Right, so on the DMMCHECK Plus, we've got it on the AC voltage selection over here, on the AC setting on my amp probe, I can select Hertz and then pick up the frequency. And as you can see, the reference frequency of the 100 hertz oscillator goes at 99.995. So certainly this amp probe is literally just one count off that on the meter itself. Now my amp probe also has another setting for looking at logic settings, more square wave. So if I turn it up here, again, I get that frequency reading, and then I can select to look at the percent or duty cycle, and this is noting it as 49.98, and on the duty cycle, he's got it noted as exactly 50%. So this is slightly out on that count. Right, I've now gone and selected, I've hooked up to the current reference over here, which is a 1 milliamp reference. Again, I've got it on the DC setting, so the polarity obviously needs to be right. And the DC current reference should be at 0.9997. And this multimeter is at 99, so it's a couple of counts out. We can then obviously check for AC current. I flick that up, I select this to AC, and the AC current source on this should be at 1.001. And with a little flicker on this multimeter, there we go, it's actually hit it. Now again, this reference will be different on a averaging multimeter. Remember, this is true RMS on this one, so it's getting the correct reading. Right, I'm just about to go and check the resistor references, and I'm going to delta out the lead. So we've got a zero. This is the 100 ohm resistor. So that's there, and on this multimeter, our 100 ohm resistor should be at 100.05. Couple of counts out on this multimeter. We've then got a 1K reference, and the 1K should be 1.0004, not too far out. We've got a 10K. The 10K should be at 10.001, and not far off on this multimeter. We then have 100K, and the 100K should be at 100.10, and this multimeter is spot on for that. And then, as I said, these are linked in series, so you can obviously measure right across them and obviously add up your references to see what you're getting. Right, so next what I've gone and done, I've gone and hooked it up to my oscilloscope. I've got it across the voltage measurement and set for AC, just so we can go and have a look at the AC signal that is being used. So there we go. As you can see, it's a square wave centered around the zero lines. That's why it's bipolar. It's got two polarities. If we go and have a look at some of the measurements, just have a look, we can see it's going at around 100 hertz. He's noted it as 99.995 hertz, and we can see it's jiggling just a little bit there on that. The peak to peak is about 10.3, 10.5. Okay, if we bring up all the measurements, on the screen here, what we can see, it obviously provides a fair bit of information, but what I'm interested in, it obviously notes the frequency, and then the duty cycle is noted here at exactly 50%, which is what he actually quotes. Right, so now it's time to see, get a relatively good idea at how accurate this device is. I have got it hooked up with clips on the bench. Obviously, it's going to be out of view while we do these tests. I've got it hooked up to my Fluke 8846A, which is a 6.5 digit multimeter. Now, there's a few things to point out here. Even though this is 6.5 digits, the resolution that I can get kind of really, I can call an accurate reading, is probably only down to 3 readings on this. And that's something I kind of point out when I did a video on both my HP and this, is that if you do want an absolute reading, you need a high resolution, because your accuracy kind of knocks off several digits. So I can only with certainty say down to 3 digits that this is accurate, and as you can see, there's a bit of noise or flutter on those last digits. Now if we look at Doug's reference for 5 volts DC, he's got it as 5.0000, so I'm certainly down to 3 places that I can be assured of. That's his reference, and it certainly looks to be good. So let's go and change to the AC setting. Right, and on Doug's AC setting, he's calling it 5.999, and mine is sitting at, again, so there's only potentially a ball hairs difference here, and if anything, my meter's probably not showing it correctly, but there we go, so almost spot on. Right, and I've just switched over to the DC reference, and it should be 0.9997, and I've got 0.9998. So again, if any meter is out here, I'm probably out, but just again, just to give you a good idea of how accurate his reference is. Right, we're now looking at the AC current for the 1 milliamp reference, and again, his is 1.001, and let's have a look, 1. Again, probably just ball hairs out, and I would again probably say that if anything's out, my meter's out. Right, so the next thing we're looking at is the frequency. He's got 99.995, and ball hairs, that's basically what we got there. Right, next we're going through the resistors. I'm on the 100 ohm resistor. I have zeroed out the leads. He's got noted as 100.05, and again, if we're rounding, then we add 100.5. We're now down to the 1K resistor, and he's got that noted as 1.0004. And again, if we're rounding, that's exactly what we've got. Right, so now we're down to the 10K, which is noted as 10.001, 10.001. We're on it. Right, we're now onto the 100K resistor, and you can see it's noted as 100.10, no problems there. Right, so I hope that provided some value. You know, besides seeing the kind of functionality of a great little reference like this, you know, anyone who goes out to purchase it, if you don't have any really high resolution equipment, you're not going to be able to verify it. And ultimately, you're not buying it to verify it, you're buying it to obviously reference and check your digital multimeter. But it is comforting to know, and I've done this with the normal DMM check as well in another video, that what he quotes certainly does seem to be the case on a measurement, on a good resolution meter. So hats off to Doug at Voltage Standard. I will post the details below, so you can, if you are interested, you can go buy these directly from him. But I thank him very much for providing me with these units anyway. Thanks very much, and I'll catch you soon for the next video. Cheers.
Tester.co.uk